ప్రపంచ టీకాల రాజధానిగా హైదరాబాద్ మారిందని మంత్రి కేటీఆర్ అన్నారు. టీకాల రాజధాని హైదరాబాద్ అని చెప్పుకోవడం గర్వకారణమని పేర్కొన్నారు. భారత్ బయోటెక్ సంస్థ కోవాక్సిన్ టీకాను తీసుకొచ్చిందని గుర్తు చేశారు. దేశీయ టీకాను తీసుకొచ్చిన భారత్ బయోటెక్ కృషి గర్వకారణమన్నారు. ప్రముఖ ఫార్మా కంపెనీలు హైదరాబాద్ లో తమ కార్యకలాపాలను మరింత విస్తరిస్తున్నాయని, ఫార్మా రంగంలో హైదరాబాద్ కు ఎదురు లేదని మంత్రి కేటీఆర్ పేర్కొన్నారు.
And when vaccine manufacturing was being talked about, I think one of the three stops the Honorable Prime Minister made was again in Hyderabad. It goes to show you the strength of the life sciences ecosystem. I think that for that one simple reason, and for how Hyderabad's life sciences ecosystem has responded to this pandemic in the last 1 year, I think you guys deserve a huge round of applause from the entire, and not just the entire administration, but I think from the entire, you know, humanity, not just in Hyderabad but across the world as well. So my compliments, my congratulations on all the efforts that have been put in the last 1 year, and I welcome you all, and those of you who are here, and also those of you who are joining us virtually to BioAsia 2021. BioAsia 2021 marks the 18th edition of this prestigious annual flagship event, and I'm extremely pleased that we have continued to hold this tradition by conducting the event even in the midst of this pandemic. As the world is walking a perilous path to fight one of the most challenging health crises of our times, I strongly believe that the deliberations at this year's event will be more relevant and more contextual than ever. 2020 has had a profound and a long-lasting impact on lives around the world. The economic and social disruption caused by the pandemic is devastating, with over 2.45 million human lives lost globally. That is 24.5 lakh people losing their lives globally. With the world still grappling over this and getting used to the new normal, I would like to use this occasion once again to thank all the frontline workers, including healthcare and public services workers, scientists, among others, who worked tirelessly during these unprecedented times amongst social and personal challenges. Without their selfless efforts, we wouldn't be able to reach this far. On a positive note, our scientists and entrepreneurs have given the life sciences sector its moment in the spotlight with accelerated development of vaccines, diagnostics, and therapeutics.